Welcome to the first vlog of Crossing Coordinates here in Australia. I mean, look at all that red dirt around us. Where else could we be? This is our first vlog. It will more or less be about the start of our road trip and starting your own road trip. So to make it a bit easier and to break it down, we divided it up in three different tips how to start your road trip down here in Australia.
Starting a road trip, especially down under, which is the perfect country to start in, sounds super exciting. But to be honest, it's actually super boring. That's because you have a lot of things to do that you need to arrange and sort out and pay, which is of course not nice. But the three tips Thijs told you about are gonna make your life a little bit easier, so let's start with them. Tip number two, Regio. Definitely the most boring one of all. That's why I placed it on number two, because number three is the most fun. Shopping. Let's get back on the road and tell you all about it.
Tip number one, car or van. To start your road trip here in Australia, you obviously need a vehicle. And to make it easy, you basically have the choice between a four-wheel drive or a classic camper van. Let's talk about the four-wheel drive first. I guess for us the biggest pro of a four-wheel drive is lots of places here in Australia are four-wheel drive only. It gives you really the opportunity to go on an adventure.
Another pro, and that's the one we really like, is with a four-wheel drive you can put a tent on top, and that means that you can separate your living area and your sleeping area, which is very nice. Then we come to, I think, the pro of a camper van, which is exactly the opposite of a four-wheel drive, and that's the fact that you have everything in one space and you can just lock the door and leave, for which with a four-wheel drive with a tent on top you have to fold your tent in.
For us it takes like half an hour to pack up really everything and go, as in with a camper van just lock your door and go. I mean, that's a huge difference, I guess.
Another pro of a camper van, I think, is that they're super pretty and very Instagram worthy, but you don't agree with that.
For us, we chose for the four-wheel drive to do that really adventurous part and to have the option to go off-road. And I mean, we have a really, really cool Nissan Patrol from 1992, and it has this really boxy look to it, and it is gorgeous.
So, wrap down tip number one, choose your vehicle, van or car.
Tip number two is about Regio. Honestly, the most boring of all, because it is about registration of your car. Basically, what it means, rules differ from state to state, so it's really important to figure out which one is the easiest for you to get that car on your name. For us it was WA, but yeah, of course, I guess it also differs from person to person, what is easier, what you find easy, and what price is more interesting for you, because also that differs from state to state. So definitely check that out before you buy the car, or you might have a problem with getting that car on your name. And last but not least, tip number three is shopping.
Shopping!
You can basically divide this up in necessity and luxury. So let's talk about necessity first.
The most important thing when you buy a car, and especially in Australia where everything is so far apart, it's important that you have everything you need in your car. So say for example, petrol tanks, water tanks, enough food,
but also like a jack and some tools to change your wheel to your spare wheel, all that stuff that you really need to get your car going when it breaks down and there's no one around to really help you.
Then we get to the fun part, which is luxury. And for luxury, I think you should look into the things you need and you use every day. For example, camp chairs, which I found very important.
And we made some really fun footage for you to see how important Jasmine thinks chairs are actually are.
Beauty.
Functional.
So I tried this beauty and this beauty, but I have to be honest.
This one is better.
Not only chairs, but also very important is a fridge or an esky. But we get to that into a different vlog because that was a story on
itself.
But I think if you have that, you have your plates, you have your cutlery, nice blankets. I mean, what more do you need?
The places where you can get this stuff for us was Kmart.
Kmart is fabulous. They have everything quite on trend and it's super, super cheap. And that's the same for Target. The other one is Bunnings. It's for all your hardware.
Everything that you need for that necessity part of your car.
And then the last one is BCF.
Boating, fishing, camping.
Nee, boating, camping, fishing. It's very difficult.
Yeah.
But there you can find camping chairs, everything you need for daily life.
That were our three tips to start your road trip. So hopefully they were a bit helpful.
Now the nice part of the vlog begins. We started our road trip already, and as we said, or did we say, we started out in Perth. Perth we really liked, but we didn't see a lot of it because we were busy getting our car ready to go on the road. We did see something spectacular, and I even dare to bet that nobody of you knew that this sport existed.
We were invited by a local to go to his underwater hockey game. He's part of the national team and they were training, and it was really cool to see actually. It was quite unusual.
We even put the GoPro in the water so you can see for yourself how it looks like. I think we should leave it at this for the first vlog. We hope you enjoyed and promise next time we tell you more about our life and the trips we have been doing. If you liked it, please like and subscribe. And if you want to follow us, because the vlog is behind on us, actually quite a bit, so follow us on Instagram. And that is?
travelblog.crossingcoordinates.